is a growing industry, yet the government hasn't done much to track it, let alone regulate it. What that means for the creator economy, that's coming up next on Marketplace. It's 6:30.
WNYC supporters include Building for the Arts, working to expand access to the performing arts for New Yorkers of all ages through its programs Music in the Brain, the American Playwriting Foundation, and Theater Row. More at bfany.org.
If you believe democracy requires a free press, your station is WNYC, 93.9 FM and AM 820, NPR News and the New York Conversation.
Marketplace is supported by McDermott Will and Emery, lawyers working to level the field for entrepreneurs of color by knocking down barriers to business success. McDermottRise.MWE.com.
Okay, where was I?
I don't know, Jay. Where were you?
Inflation was coming down.
All right. From American Public Media, this is Marketplace.
Marketplace is supported by Amazon Business, helping provide a smarter, easier way to get the supplies businesses need to thrive. Amazon Business, your partner for smart business buying. And by Raymond James, tailored wealth management, banking, and capital markets solutions for clients' unique needs. Disclosures at RaymondJames.com.
In Los Angeles, I'm Kai Rizdahl. It is Thursday today, the 9th day of November. Good as always to have you along, everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, from a speech he gave this morning, Jay Powell and the future of this economy in 4.5 easy sentences. Number one.
We know that ongoing progress toward our 2% goal is not assured.
Two.
Inflation has given us a few head fakes along the way.
Three.
If it becomes appropriate to tighten policy further, we will not hesitate to do so.
Four.
We will continue to move carefully, however.
And a half.
Allowing us to address both the risk of being misled by a few good months of data and the risk of over-tightening.
All right, so look, here's what that was. That was the chairman of the Federal Reserve talking not to you or me, but to the markets, stocks, bonds, and otherwise, which, as we have been telling you since Powell's press conference last Wednesday, have decided somehow amongst themselves that the Fed is not only done raising rates, but it might even start cutting rates. Powell, as he said, is not fallen for the head fake. And indeed, on Wall Street today, having heard the chair, stocks down, bond yields up, details, numbers, y'all know the drill. That head fake Chair Powell was talking about this morning was all about data. Data that lately has made it look pretty good for the Fed's done crowd, right? And the Fed does, to be clear, have a ton of data at its fingertips. We, though, are going to do a 180 here to something we don't have a lot of federal data on at all. I saw this in the Washington Post the other day, a headline that said, "Millions work in content creation in official records. They barely exist." Content creation, influencing, right, is a huge industry. So you might imagine my surprise that the feds don't really know all that much about it. Drew Harwell shared the byline on the piece in the Post. Drew, thanks for coming on.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Could you define a term for me, first of all, just so we all have a baseline here? Creator economy. What is that?
It is the business of online influencers. It's the people, many of them young, but not all, who use their phones and computers to make the content that fills our internet. And, you know, we used to sort of poo-poo them as just influencers, that they just did fashion and makeup, but they cover basically every genre now, and they are a giant industry in the U.S., the $250 billion industry that touches a lot of culture and politics and also just business.
And the reason we got a hold of you is because of this piece that you and your colleague Taylor Lorenz wrote, which basically says the government doesn't really know much about this industry, how big it is, what it does, who's in it, all of that.
Yeah, which I find really interesting because at this point, you know, Facebook is 20 years old. YouTube is old. This is a market of millions of people around the world who work as creators or influencers. And yet we don't really have a sense of how big this market is. We don't have any kinds of great labor protections for them in the U.S. And yet they really are a job. But also a lot of young people are seeing this as a career path. You have lots of young people who say, I don't want to be an astronaut or a rock star anymore. I want to become a YouTuber or a streamer. And I just find that really interesting. You have this huge market of young people wanting to become this thing that the government keeps zero track of.
We should point out here that although the high profile influencers obviously get all the high profile stuff, most people in this industry are not making a bazillion dollars.
Yeah, it's a huge 1% economy.
Right.
You have the stars like, you know, Mr. Beast, who are at the upper crust, who make millions of dollars. And then there's a giant creator middle class that try.